Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear students, ladies and gentlemen, this is Shaukat Yad, your teacher of company law.
Wa alaikum assalam, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Waiting for a good 10 minutes, I could have only 26 out of 37 or 34 students. Anyways, welcome to you again. We are going to start the company law for the last two weeks. I have been talking for on preliminary things which were necessary for you to know before starting your company law course. Today we are properly and formally going to start our course on company law. And I would like in the beginning to remind you again, what does company mean, how it is formed. So in the simplest possible words, my dear students, a company is just, a group of people who are jointly running a business, the property. But let me know whether you can hear me properly, my voice, the voice is clear or not, please, someone should reply.
थोड़ा सा इशू आ रहा है, क्लियर ज्यादा नहीं आ रहा.
व्हाट्स द इशू
सर? क्लियर है.
इज द वॉइस क्लियर?
यस सर.
वॉइस क्लियर
फॉर एवरीबॉडी?
यस सर, क्लियर है.
गुलाम हैदर, यू माइट हैव सम प्रॉब्लम विद योर
यस सर, आई थिंक आई शुड हैव टू चेंज माय हैंड फ्री.
ऑलराइट, थैंक. सो एज आई वाज टेलिंग यू दैट अ कंपनी इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल. They are jointly running a trade or business for profit, okay? But partnership, as against this, partnership is also a group of people pooling together their resources, their finances, and running a business for profit. Then what's the difference? The main difference is that company is a distinct personality from The members in a partnership, they are called partners, while members in the company are called shareholders. So in the case of a partnership, that is to say a firm, you see, a firm is not a distinct personality from its partners. You see, firm is the collective name of the partners. When partners are referred to individually, they are called. When they are referred to in collectively, that is called firm, okay? But the position in the company form of business is totally different. And company is totally distinct personality from its shareholders. Difference number two between the two forms of business organization is that the liability of the partners is unlimited, while the liability of shareholders is limited. We have talked about it in detail, that what does unlimited liability mean, okay? Difference number three between the company form of business organization and corporate form of business organization is that the owners of a partnership are the partners, while the owner of the business in corporate form of in company form of business are not the shareholder. Shareholders are theoretically not the owner. The owner is the company, and company is a personality, a juristic personality. You see, me and you, we are natural persons, while a company is a juristic person or legal person. And this is called legal person because law creates it. Law, it is created under a legal fiction. Law presumes that there is a personality which owns and runs a business. This company has more or less the same, this juristic personality or legal personality has more or less the same rights and duties as a natural person has. Okay. Like a natural person can buy and sell. So same is the case with the company. A company may sell and may buy in its own name. A natural person, me and you, we can buy and sue against others. And company also can sue in its own name, you see, in a court of law. These are the differences. Then question arises, when they are same, when in both of the business organization people, they invest their money for the profit, then why companies? The chief consideration behind the creation of the concept of company form of business organization is to get rid of unlimited liability. Unlimited liability is a very, very, unwanted, rather dreadful element. Okay? How? Because if your liability is unlimited, if a partnership comes across a loss which is beyond your investment, you see, then you will be required to sell your own property, your personal property, which had nothing to do with the firm, will be taken and sold. So your personal properties, in the case of a partnership, are always exposed to this danger. Okay. Well, so it's not the case in the company. Since the owner in the company form of business organization is the company and not the shareholders, that's why the shareholders' liability is limited up to their shares. I mean, what they can lose, the shareholders, at the most. Their investment, which they have invested in the form of buying shares of the company. But their private property, just suppose if company comes across a loss, which is many, many times beyond its capital, you see? So since the company is the owner, the company's liability is unlimited, while the shareholders, since they are not owners, that's why their liability is not unlimited and their private properties or not exposed to the danger of unlimited liability. This was the logic behind the creation. Because people used to hesitate to invest in a proprietorship or in partnership form of business organization. Just to encourage the people to come down and to invest in the business, you see, this idea or concept of company form of business organization give them guarantee that their private properties would be saved if the company comes across a huge loss. That's the idea. Now, how company can be created? There are two ways. I mean, you see, the company is created, there are certain requirements, certain documents which are prepared, certain other requirements which are to be fulfilled by the people. Those people who are interested and who are working for creation of a company, they are called promoters. So promoters, they prepare all these documents, they pay fees, they do everything which is required for creation of the company, and they file an application with the Security and Exchange Commission of Pakistan. And when everything is okay, you see, the company is incorporated and the certificate of incorporation is granted to the company. There are now question here arises that a company is is like a newly born baby. A newly registered company is like a newly born baby, having no money to start business. Question here arises that from where the company, newly registered company, would arrange capital for running it, for starting and running its business. Okay, there are two ways. Number one is that the promoters will buy the shares of the company. Okay, the company would mention in its memorandum of association, one of its most important documents, that how much capital it's planning to have. Just suppose the company has decided to have a capital of 100 rupees, 100,000 rupees. Just suppose 100,000 rupees, which means which in Urdu is called luck, but some people write it in Urdu, in English as well, luck, but which is not an English term. An English term for this is 100,000. The company is planning to have a capital, a share capital. It is called share capital because it is shared by the shareholders. So it has decided to have, just suppose, a share capital of 1,000 rupees with which it intends to start its future business. Okay. It will also decide that it is going to distribute its share capital into how many shares. Just suppose that the company has decided to share its capital of 100,000 rupees into 100 shares, which will mean that every share will have a value of 1,000 rupees. So just suppose that the promoters are 5 people. Everybody will buy, you see, 20 shares out of 100 shares, okay, and will pay to the company the price. So after selling its 100 shares to five promoters, the company would have in its hand, you see, 100,000 rupees, with which a question is in your mind, a beginner of company law must arise, that who would run this business? And who would collect this money? And who would deposit this money? Because the company is an imaginary person. You see, in reality, it has got no existence. It has no body. It has no hands to sign. It has no tongue to speak. So there, you see, there would be a board of directors. There would be some people mostly from amongst the shareholders who would be elected as the directors. And these directors would be functioning as the agents of the company, and they would arrange everything. They would run this business on behalf of the company as the agents of the company. So there is nothing to worry about. You see, these directors will receive on behalf of the company 100,000 rupees and will start the business, will run the business with the consideration of the shareholders, and they will, when they will, you see, make profit, that profit will be distributed to them among the shareholders, and they, the directors themselves, would be mostly 99.99% would be out of the shareholders. So in this way, you see, this is the one thing. The other way is that there is a shopkeeper. There is a shop. Okay. Just suppose Allah Ditta and Kala Khan Grocery. This is their name. This is a shop. And they are running as a partnership. Or Allah Ditta alone as a sole proprietor. Anyway, just take the example of the partnership. Two people are running this business, Kalahan and Allah Ditta. And the name of the business is Allah Ditta and Kalahan Groceries. They are selling groceries in their business. So someone tells them that, look, if your business is at loss, your private, since you are the owners, you too are the owners, and your business may come across a loss which is many, many times more than your capital, the whole entire worth of your business, then your private property will be taken by the court and sold to their business to pay the creditors. Okay. So here question arises that if you convert, you see, someone tells the owners, the partners, that if you convert this partnership into a company form of business, then business would be the same. The managing person would be the same. The shop would be the same. You people would be the same. You will be running the business with the same capital. But at least your private property would be saved if your business comes across a loss which is beyond the whole entire work of the business, just converted. So they converted, they prepared the document, they applied to the Security and Exchange Commission of Pakistan, and eventually the company is created with the name of Allah Gupta and Kala Khan Private Groceries Private Limited. Now, again, question would arise here that this Allah Gupta and Kala Khan Private Limited company would arrange its capital in this way. How? So this Allah Gupta and Kala Khan would make a contract with the company and would sell their business to the company. But instead of paying the company, instead the company paying them, you see, money as the price, you see, the company would pay them shares. So this 100 shares would be paid to Kala Khan, and you see, this Allah Gupta will have 5 shares and Kala Khan would have 5.